Welcome to the Maria Goretti Corner. You know, my mom, when we were kids, she used to keep insisting that we learn how to make roti. And my sister and me used to laugh at her behind her back, of course. And we used to be thinking that, so we go to school and we go to college and we do all this, we study so much, and then at the end of the day, you have to make rotis. But the fact of the matter is, roti is really important in life. And it's something every girl and boy needs to know how to make. And roti is something that mixed with anything just tastes yummy and is really, really, you know, it's good sustenance. With the roti dough, I'm going to make my version of a lachha paratha. Right now, I'm going to just show you a simple roti dough. So I've taken 200 grams of whole wheat flour, or as we lovingly call it, atta. To this, I'm going to add 150 ml of water. I'm going to add a little salt to taste. Right now, I will just do a roti dough for you. This dough is going to need more than 150 ml of water. You can't be measuring this. You have to feel it and go accordingly. The gluten is set free, basically. And you get nice, soft, fluffy rotis. Okay, to this now, I'm going to add a tablespoon foil. Okay, this dough is beautifully kneaded. It's lovely, it's soft, and it's ready to make fluffy rotis. Now to this, I'm going to add a tablespoon of ajwain, which I'm going to dry roast. The dough is all ready. Now all we have to do is cut this, make them into tiny little balls, and make our lachha parathas with this. I'm not the best roti maker in town. I always used to make funny shapes of various countries, and I've decided it works. So this is done. Take some ghee. So you spread the ghee onto this. You sprinkle this with a bit of your ajwain, and then just cut into it a bit. And then roll it. Fold it a bit. So what you're actually doing is giving it a whole lot of layers. You've already put the ghee in it, so it's full of yummy desi goodness. So you keep rolling this from the ends. Fabulous. Okay, now that this is done, all you have to do is smear it with a bit of ghee so that you can now stick it together and roll it in like a little ballerina twirling. That is it. And then for the last time, pinch it well together so nothing opens up. Don't make this too thin. Just keep it a bit thick so that you don't open all the layers. And it's ready. Put it onto a medium flame. Guys, my lachha paratha is done. It takes about 4 to 5 minutes. Now I'm going to add some ghee to it before I crush it. Oof. Homemade ghee is just something else. Well, this is done, and you can serve this with anything you like. But I'm going to have it with my yummy mint chicken. You know, the thing about this is you cannot keep it. So it is from the pan into your mouth. That's the way this has got to be done. Mmm. So if you want the recipe of the chicken, don't forget to click here. And if you like our lachha paratha, don't forget to comment, like, share, subscribe. And I'll see you again soon, only on the Maria Goretti Corner. I need to eat this really quickly. Mm. Oh my God.